Hallelujah. Jesus is on the throne. Are we happy to be in church this morning? Amen. Praise the Lord. I want to appreciate God for each and every one of you. And I want to thank God for his faithfulness in our lives. Thanking God for everything that he is doing and has been doing in our respective lives. In Jesus' name, praise the Lord. I want to thank God for making it possible for me to be with us in fellowship. Amen. It was not easy staying away from here. Praise the Lord. But in everything, we appreciate God. We thank God because God always has a purpose. Amen. Many times we may not fully understand what God is doing, but I'm here to encourage us this morning to remain faithful with God. Amen. Hallelujah. He said, be followers of them who through faith and patience has obtained the promise. Amen. Followers of them who through faith and patience. When God wanted to walk in the life of David, he used the father to send David into the wilderness. Amen. Whilst others were in the town cruising and enjoying themselves, David was in the wilderness being tutored by God. Amen. Praise the Lord. When the time came when God was ready to take him to another phase, hallelujah, God sent Samuel. And from then on, David began another phase of his life. I want to simply tell us and let us know that everything we are doing in life is for a purpose. Amen. If you are a believer in God, you just have to continue to do what? Trust him. Amen. Be followers of them who through faith and patience have obtained the promise. And so when the word of God comes to you, how many of us realize that in life we are on a journey? Amen. We are on a journey. You may not realize it, but that is the truth. We are on a journey. The Bible said of Abraham and his sons, when God called Abraham and he took his sons and they began to go on a journey. The Bible says they were looking for a city whose builder and maker is God. They were looking for the city. I don't know which city you are looking for, but Abraham and his sons were looking for a city not built with hands, a city whose foundation is God. Hallelujah. That was what they were looking for. I want to tell us that God doesn't make any mistake. Hallelujah. Amen. God does not make mistake. I want to appreciate God because I normally tell us here that it would be lack of understanding and foolhardy for us to believe that we are the only ones who have understanding of the gospel. Amen? When Elijah was complaining that he was the only prophet left, God laughed. He said, I have kept for myself 7,000 prophets who have not bowed themselves to, hallelujah. And so, and far away, thousands of miles away from where we are, in a different world, I was able to see with my own eyes, hallelujah, people that share the same faith, hallelujah, that believe in the same things that we believe in. And of course, when you come here, you may be wondering in your heart, oh, we are so few in number. This must be a personal revelation and understanding. Amen? But I was amazed and shocked beyond words to see that there are people of a truth God has kept who have not bowed themselves to Baal. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. And so they speak the same language. They share the same faith. Hallelujah. And so when they also saw that my communication was the same, there was great rejoicing. Hallelujah. The same way they were surprised was the same way I was surprised. Amen. He said, could any good thing come out from Nigeria? They saw a good thing. Hallelujah. And they testified with their own mouths. Hallelujah. And so God does not make mistakes. Are you hearing what I'm saying? You may be in the wilderness and it looks like, oh, God is wasting time with you. That's a lie. Amen? At the fullness of time, praise the Lord. At the fullness of time. Because everything is according to the purpose of the kingdom. Everything is geared towards the kingdom. And so I want to continue to encourage you. The Bible says, be ye followers of them who through faith and patience obtained the promise. Any person that walks with God must be a woman, a man of patience. You must be patient. You must be patient with God. Hallelujah. God is not in the business of the way the world chases after the things. Are you hearing what I'm saying? No, he's not in that kind of business. The do or die business. No. God would want his people to be properly grounded. Hallelujah. And moreover, when your eyes is focused on the prize, on what you are looking for, what you know that you believe in, you just stay there and continue to trust God. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. The substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. And so having a clear understanding of your purpose, your mission here on earth, I told us that we are like the wind. We are like the wind. A believer is like the wind. He said, they that are born of the Spirit, he said, they are like wind. He said, no one knows where it's coming from, and no one knows where it's going. The wind, that's who we are. You don't know where it's coming from. You don't know where it's going. Praise the Lord. And so when you hear people talk, they tell you, plan my life planned out. I have no plan for my life. Amen. I am not ashamed to say it. Hallelujah. I have no plans whatsoever. My business here is the business of the kingdom of God. Hallelujah. I don't have two businesses. My business is the business of the kingdom. If there's anything I should have planned for, it should be the business of God, not worldly plan. Amen? Hallelujah. But if even that one, hallelujah, you still have to depend on the Spirit of God. The Bible says, they that are the sons of God are led by the Spirit of God. So even in the business of God, you depend on the Spirit of God. In other words, you don't have any plan. So talk less of your own stuff. Amen? And so we are like the wind. Amen. We are ready. At every time the Lord will call upon us. Amen? We are ready to go to the wilderness, to go to anywhere where the kingdom will have need of us. Amen? Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Paul, a single man who was able to preach the whole gospel in the whole of Asia. Amen. A single man who preached the gospel in the whole of Asia. by the Spirit of God. Are you hearing what I'm saying? So you just need to depend on the Spirit of God. That's why I said, they that are led by the Spirit are the sons of God. I met a lot of people that it could only be God that will direct them my path. Hallelujah. And when they begin to hear the wisdom that God has blessed me with, they stand in awe. Hallelujah. And of course, knowing fully well that God wanted me to share with them what he has blessed me with, it was no surprise that all of them had similar stories to tell. Amen? Similar stories to tell. Praise the Lord. He said, prophet is not recognized in his hometown. He's without honor. Hallelujah. That's the way it is. So when in your own town you are not recognized, that's what the Bible says, that you will not be recognized. Amen? But people from other places will quickly see the grace of God. Hallelujah. And recognize it. Amen. Because suddenly in a few minutes, certain questions they've had all their lives begins to pop in their face. Pam, pam. And this word you hear here, you think maybe, can we preach it another place? The people there, they are radio. In fact, some of them were even thinking that I have come there to stay. Hallelujah. So me, I'm weighing my options. Since you people don't appreciate me, maybe I should go there and stay now with the people who appreciate me. Hallelujah. Eh? Praise the Lord. Yeah, local champion now. You don't believe what I'm saying, what I tell you people here. So you think, oh, maybe I'm just saying my own thing. Eh? Praise the Lord. But what you don't know, that there are people who are hungry for the truth. Amen? Oh, but you are here. You think we are joking in this place. Hallelujah. I saw in a glimpse what the Lord had been saying in my heart. Amen? He's been telling me, you know, ever since, you know, we began this journey. He said, your ministry is not a local ministry. It's not a local ministry. It's a ministry that will affect nations. Are you hearing what I'm saying? A ministry that will affect nations. But right now, it doesn't look anything like it, near it. But when the Lord says something, you know it will come to pass. Are you hearing what I'm saying? It will come to pass. Because I met several individuals representing several nations who were loving the word of God as it was coming. Hallelujah. People of different nations. I'm not talking about Nigerians or Igbo. I'm talking about people from different nations of the world loving the word of God. Just a glimpse. Hallelujah. Because this is an international ministry that will impact nations. God is, the world is shaping up. Oh. I told you that before. God is in the business of shaking the world. He's shaking the world. He is shaking the world so that the people who are called will respond to this gospel from the nations of the earth. Are you hearing what I'm saying? The world is being shaped. Hallelujah. The world is being shaped. When I began to tell them about their system, the system that they are running, they are living in, and how the system has held them hostage and bondage, and in bondage, they were like, how do you know? Hallelujah. Bible says God has made us custodians of the mysteries. Hallelujah. We possess mysteries. We know mysteries. I don't need to be in your environment to tell you what's happening in your environment. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Because the word of God is enough light to know what the enemy is doing to you. Praise the Lord. And so I want to encourage each and every one of us. And I want to let you know that God has a plan for your life. Amen. And all that you need to do is to continue to mind the business of the kingdom. Continue to allow God to work out his purpose in you. Because you don't know where you are going to be found tomorrow. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Praise the Lord. Everywhere that gospel carried Apostle Paul, he impacted nations. Are you hearing what I'm saying? With the gospel of the truth, not the adulterated gospel. Oh, hallelujah. Those people are tired of such rubbish now. You don't have, if I had come with such garbage, nobody would pay attention to you. Are you hearing what I'm saying? You don't have, what are you going to say now? Because you are telling them the same things they know. Amen? Hallelujah. It's only when you come with this kind of knowledge, they are hearing, they think they, you know, they are hearing things that they have not heard before. Are you hearing what I'm saying? And so God has done a lot in our lives. Amen? Praise the Lord. I told us sometime, we have a very good record, as it were, of the things we have been saying in this ministry over the years. Amen. We have them on CD, we have them on tapes, we have them on the internet. Praise the Lord. And so you can avail yourself. You can avail yourself of the word of God. I remember the last time I was talking to us, I said, what else do you want to hear? Every day you come here, you hear mysteries. But the problem is, what do you do with what you are hearing? Amen? You know, in a football stadium, so many people come into the stadium. There are those that come as referees, those that come as sports fans, all manner of people come to the stadium. But there are, in that stadium, there are also main actors in the form of the coaches and the players. Maybe some of you here are fans. What your own is to cheer the players and the coaches as they do their thing. What do the fans go home with at the end of the day? I said, what do the fans go home with at the end of the day? Nothing. Absolutely nothing. Some will even kill opposing fans. But who are the people who go home with something? The players and the coaches, is it not? The others go empty-handed. Only the players and the coaches go with something. Am I speaking? So are you going to be a fan? You don't want to be a player. Hallelujah. You want to be, that we belong, maybe by that time you say, oh minister, I am a bit on the ministry. As a minister, fan. Eh? But God has given you an opportunity to be a part and parcel of that commission. But what are you doing? Inuenu inuane. You are not ready to lift a finger. You are doing yourself. Are you hearing what I'm saying? You're doing yourself. Not God, not any person. Because God is always in the business of preparing his own. Are you hearing what I'm saying? And I keep telling us, we are always bothered about things that are of no consequence. We consume ourselves with things that are of no consequence. And when you allow, that's why he said, seek ye the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and everything that you need shall be what? Added unto you. If you look at the life of Jesus, Jesus traveled very light. Amen? Jesus traveled very, very light. Very, very light. He didn't have too much. Not because he couldn't afford those things, or, you know, he couldn't gather stuff if he wanted. But if you are going to stay in tune with God, you are going to be a light traveler. Amen. Remember, we are on a journey here on earth. Are you with me? We are on a journey here on earth. It is very easy for you to miss God. Are you hearing what I'm saying? It is very easy for you to miss God. Very easy. I used to tell you, you have only one problem here on earth. The only problem you have here on this earth is your relationship with God. That's the only problem you have. But that's one thing the enemy will try to make you ignorant of. He will try to make you believe that this is not your problem. That your problem is this, that, and that, and that, and that, minus that relationship. Oh, you need to have money. You need to have this. You need to be there. You need to get this. You need to do that. Amen. It is so easy to miss God. Are you hearing what I'm saying? So easy to miss God. So you ask yourself, what do you need? What is it that you need? Amen. What do you need? Because if you don't know what you need, you will not understand and you will not see God. Hallelujah. The only thing you need in this life is your relationship with God. Why? Why is it necessary? Why is that important? That is the only thing, because you are on a journey here on earth. God has a purpose for you here on earth. If that relationship is not there, you will miss out on God. Amen. Are you getting what I'm saying? This is the reason why Jesus traveled light, because he didn't want to miss out on God. Are you hearing what I'm saying? That's why when that man came to Jesus and was asking, how can I have eternal life? Jesus said, okay, go and keep the law. He said, I've been doing that. Okay, Jesus said, okay, it's true. He said, one thing remains. He said, go and sell all that you have and give to the poor. Yes. And then come and follow me. Come and travel light. Praise the Lord. Come and travel light. The man, he couldn't understand it. Amen? Travel light. The Bible says the man went away sad. Why? Because he had too many possessions. Jehovah Buliela Menu. Aya, 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 aya. Oh! Aya, aya. You've lost your direction to God long time ago, and you are busy dancing in church. Jehovah Buliela Melu. Aya, aya. And you don't know that thing you are dancing for and say you are thanking God for is the reason why you have lost direction with God. You've lost contact with God. And you are in church doing Jehovah Buliela Melu. Aya, aya. Then the pastor will be dancing with you. Aya, aya. Because of the tithe and the other things that will be coming to the church. Blind. That's why Jesus says, if the blind leads the blind, he said, all of them will do what? Will fall into a ditch. Take it, receive it. This week is your week. God is lifting you. God is taking you. Do you think those things are hard for me to do? It's very easy. Take it, receive it. I shall talk, preach on, pastor. Yay! What is that? Hallelujah. But that's what people want to hear. Receive it. Take it. But what they don't understand is that long time ago, they lost the address of God. And they are in church as deacons and elders and all manner of positions and praising God for the blessings. Hallelujah. Jehovah Gozielam or Gozielai. He said, having food and raiment, do what? Be content. He said, for they that will be rich will do what? Will lose the address of God. That's what he said. Amen. They that will be rich will lose the address of God. That's what stuff does to you. Are you hearing what I'm saying? That is what stuff does to you. It will cause you to do what? Lose the address of God. Onye nwere nti nya nuru Nyanuru onye nwere nti nyanuru okwu Chineke onye nwere nti nyanuru nyanuru onye nwere nti nyanuru okwu Chineke onye nwere nti nyanuru nyanuru onye nwere nti nyanuru okwu Chineke. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. When they say poverty is a cause, I don't agree from that perspective. Yes. But if this is what they mean, then that might be true. Because the reason why some of you struggle with this kind of messages is because of the poverty mentality. And when you come across people who have seen it all, and you preach this message, their heart is gladdened. And they rejoice in the Lord thy God. Hallelujah. Eh? But for you who poverty, you have not seen beyond your nose. And every day you are dreaming to be like the rich. Eh? Every day you dream to be like the rich. And so when the word of God comes to you, you want to be like the rich. But people who are there already, when you preach this gospel to them, they say, yes, what you are saying is the truth. But for those people who are still aspiring to be there, when you tell them, you become their enemy because you don't want them to come up there. Hallelujah. Amen. That is the word of God. Let me say it again. Stuff will make you to lose the address of God. You will lose God. That's why he said, you cannot serve two masters at the same time. It's either you choose one. You cannot love God and love mammon. It's not possible. Choose one. But when you seek the kingdom and his righteousness, God, who knows what you need? Are you hearing what I'm saying? He will make available to you what you need. That's it. And that is all that you need in life. You don't need more than that. Are you hearing what I'm saying? You do not need more than food and raiment. You don't need more than that. You don't need more than food. Having food and raiment, be content. You don't need more than that. You know, when you begin to seek for more than food and raiment, you will lose the address of God. You know, the Bible says, it says, they that seek to be rich, they will fall into diverse temptations and trials, which drown men in perdition and destruction. Ultimately, what is that? You have lost the address of God. He said, for the love of money is the root of all evil, which while some coveted after have made a shipwreck of their faith. What is that? Losing the address of God. Praise the Lord. That's what will happen to you. When your priority is to gain the world, you will lose the address of God. Jesus didn't need to gain the world. Are you hearing what I'm saying? I was sharing this with a friend, you know, over the phone. He also stays out there. And whilst we were talking, and you know, he didn't even understand where I was coming from. And he was trying to imago sing the popular song and the story they tell them in church. And when I began to explain to him, after explaining certain things, deep-rooted understanding, he began to lament. He said, I wish I was recording what you were saying. Hallelujah. Because he had what he has never had before. Amen. He said, I wish I was recording what you were saying. And to tell you the truth, every person I met, that was the same feeling they were having. They were like, I wish I could record these things you are telling me. You know, it's like, the questions you've been asking for all your life, suddenly the answers are coming. Pam, pam. wish I could record what you're telling me. But these are things you hear day in, day out. Familiarity doesn't mean anything to you. Hallelujah. Because you think that what we are doing is fun and games. My prayer for you is that you will sit up. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Praise the Lord. Don't just seek to be a fan. Seek to be a player. Or even better still, a coach. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Get yourself busy in the business of the kingdom of God. Grow in the knowledge of God. Grow. Take in the word of God. Allow your spirit to grow. He said, by so doing, you will be able to fulfill the will of God in your life. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. That is how it works. Don't spend your energy and your time pushing and seeking after stuff. What you are seeking for. That's what the Bible says. For they that desire to be rich will fall into many diverse temptations and trials, which drown men in perdition and destruction. God will always bring to you what to do at your doorstep. Are you hearing what I'm saying? He will always do that because he's God. Amen? And all within the boundary of what you need. Are you hearing what I'm saying? All within the boundary of what you need. When you set yourself like the people of the world, to be like the people of the world, you remove God from the equation. And when you remove God from the equation, you are on your own. Hallelujah. God is our inheritance. Amen. He is our inheritance. He is our backbone. When Abraham went out and gathered, Bible says Abraham was, rich in cattle and in gold and in silver. God called him and he said, Abraham, I am your exceeding rare reward. Hallelujah. I am your backbone. Hallelujah. Do not seek security where there is no security. And that's the problem with man. Man is seeking for security where there is no security. Amen. God is my security. Jesus lived that life. And that's why he didn't have anything. He didn't need to, because God was always with him. He had God. Now, why would a man who has God be seeking for security? Doesn't make sense. So, when people acquire stuff because they hope to have some form of security against their future, they are saying that it is that security that they trust in. Hallelujah. But when God is your security, when God is your future, like God was to Jesus, Jesus didn't need to acquire anything. He didn't need to even have anything. Because that's why I said to you, when you go in quest of stuff, you lose the address of God. If Jesus had enough money in his pocket to pay for his temple tax, how would he have known that the Holy Spirit could direct him to send Peter to go and collect coins from the mouth of the fish in order for him to pay for their tax, temple tax? How would he have done that? Will God have need to speak to him? Huh? Yes, that's what happens to you. When you acquire stuff, you shut God out. In other words, God does not need to speak to you again. What you have is now what speaks to you. That's why Paul was writing. He said, warn them that are rich that they should not put their trust in uncertain riches. Who is your security? What is God to you? Because if God is who you say that he is in your life, then you don't need anything. You don't need any security. You don't need to acquire. People acquire stuff for security because they don't trust God. Are you hearing what I'm saying? But if you trust God, you are not going to acquire for security. Are you hearing what I'm saying? But you trust God. Trusting God does not mean that you are going to be stupid and foolish. Are you hearing what I'm saying? It doesn't mean that you are going to be foolish and you're going to be stupid, in the sense that if you make 1 naira, you stand up and you finish 1 naira, and then you say, I'm trusting God, you are stupid. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Because when I ask you, what did you do with 1 naira, that 1 naira? He said, oh, I went to KFC. I went to all these boutiques and all these places. Praise the Lord. That is stupidity, because you say you are trusting God. He said, all things are lawful to me, but not all things are expedient. Not all things edify. When funds are given to you, they are given to you to expend in expedient purposes. Are you hearing what I'm saying? And things that edify. And not when you now carry the funds and you go and spend it on rubbish. And then you come out, I'm trusting God. You're a fool. And you will pay the price of being a fool. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Because when you now come out like that and you say you are trusting God, you will hear me. Are you hearing me? And you will ask God, Chineke nosekwa, Chineke nke Abraham, Chineke nke Elijah, nke Moses, nke Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, nke ma nke Jabez. Are you getting what I'm saying? When you have made a fool of yourself, all of them, and then because you have been a fool. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Praise the Lord. Even Jesus had, what was his name? Judas, holding a purse for them, meaning that they didn't finish everything that they had. Are you hearing what I'm saying? So that even if funds are given to you, it could be for today, it could be for tomorrow, it could be for the next 2 years or thereabout. When there was going to be famine in the land of Egypt, God had to send Joseph into that land so that they would begin to save for the time of famine. If they didn't do that, if they like during that time of famine, let them call God of mountain of fire or God of thunder. Hunger will kill them in famine. Is somebody hearing what I'm saying? If you like, call whichever God you want to call. Because you decided to be stupid and you think you will get away with it, you will pay for that foolishness. Are you hearing what I'm saying? So when the Bible says, having food and raiment, be content, it's not asking you to be stupid. When you say, God is my inheritance, when you say, God is my security, when you say, God is my all in all, at the end of the day, he said, they that are led by the Spirit are the sons of God. Hallelujah. Everything will have to be working by the Spirit. The Spirit will have to guide you in everything that you do in life. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Don't be stupid. And then tomorrow you are wondering, why did God bring your feet out? You brought your feet out, not God. Amen. Praise the Lord. Don't live above your means. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Don't live above your means. Stay within what you can afford. Don't try to be like any person. Every person was not created the same. Are you hearing what I'm saying? You're not like A, neither are you like B. Live your life. Praise the Lord. If it is sachet water that you can afford, drink sachet water. Don't go and look for bottled water. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Praise the Lord. Not when you want to live like a king. You are putting yourself under pressure, is it not? Automatically, the moment you set yourself up that way, you are going to end up stealing or cheating or lying or looking for one sugar daddy or sugar mommy or whatever in order to make ends meet. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Cut your coat according to your size. Not when you say you are trusting God. You are looking to live like a king when God has not told you that is the way he wants you to live. Are you following what I'm saying? Praise the Lord. So that tomorrow you will not say God has disappointed you or God has brought you to shame. You brought yourself to shame. You disappointed yourself, not God, in any way. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Praise the Lord. When the time for bottled water will come, you will drink bottled water and you will still find out that it is vanity upon vanity. Hallelujah. Because you think that those people who are eating that one, until the doctor will tell you, you see this one, don't eat again. And then when you come to a big man's house, you expect him to be eating roasted chicken, roasted turkey, roasted this. Nyana akwukwo na ifia na emezi. You now wonder, we take on you now. So, I think I'm okay now. Hallelujah. Vanity upon vanity. All is vanity. All is vanity. Praise the Lord. All these things. Praise the Lord. You will live your life and enjoy your life and not have any headache. But the moment he believes, you know, well, he's here on the other side. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Praise the Lord. Lie. Amen. Asiasi, you need to be wiser than that. Amen. Settle your heart to seek the Lord. That is all you have in this wicked world that we are living in. God is your treasure. God is your inheritance. God is everything that you and I have. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Seek him with all your heart. He said, be ye followers of them who through faith and patience have obtained the promise. Continue to walk in the path that he has set for you. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Praise the Lord. And in due time, God will bring you to that place. You know, I was discussing with somebody and I was saying that every believer, God has destined every believer to impact lives. Every believer without fail. Every person in the kingdom of God has a part to play. You have an important part to play. You have a role to play. But you will never find that role. You will never discover that role if you get carried away with how the world does its stuff. Are you hearing what I'm saying? You have a role to play. Don't be comfortable with just coming to church. So many people are comfortable with just coming to church as if that is the whole reason why God has created them. You are either lying to yourself or you are deceiving yourself. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Don't be comfortable sitting and not doing anything for the kingdom of God. Are you hearing what I'm saying? It cannot be right. It is not right. It cannot be right. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Something is definitely wrong somewhere. It's either you are not hearing well or you are totally deceiving yourself. You are in delusion. Something is not right. Every child of God has a purpose. I'm not talking about morning cry. I'm not talking about going into the bus to go and preach. I'm not talking about going into the market to go and share whatever you people share, whatever. That's not what I'm talking about. That in itself is not bad. But that's not the purpose you were created. Are you hearing what I'm saying? There is a reason why God brought you into this world. And you must seek to fulfill that destiny. You cannot be comfortable living life just anyhow. Are you hearing what I'm saying? No. Something is wrong. If you are comfortable like that, something is wrong. Something is wrong. Something is missing. You cannot be comfortable because God did not fashion you out that way. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Every child of God is unique. Everyone that is called of God is unique. There is something unique about you. There is something extraordinary about you. You are not an ordinary person. It's not for you to be coming to church. This is not the reason why God has called you. God called you to impart the kingdom. There is a way that God is going to use you to impart his kingdom. And it is left for you to discover it. It is your responsibility to discover as you continue to follow God, as you continue to yearn, as you continue to have it in your heart, not just to do the will of God, but to finish it. He said, they that hunger and thirst after righteousness shall be filled. There must be something that is driving you that is more than the ordinary. When you are just comfortable coming around to church, that's all that matters to you. You come to church like a religious thing, and then you go back just the way you are. You are kidding yourself. You are deceiving yourself because you have not really understood where you are located. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Something is still like a hindrance to you. Something is still covering your eyes. The scales have not yet fallen off your eyes. The veil, as it were, is still covering you. But the Bible says that veil has been rolled away by the blood of Jesus. But perhaps you have not allowed that blood to roll away that veil completely. You have allowed another veil to cover your face, to keep you away from seeing clearly. I wonder what that veil is. I wonder what that veil is that is covering you. The blood of Jesus has taken away the veil, but you have allowed something else to bring back that veil. And as it were, you are not seeing clearly. You are not seeing clearly. You are a man, a woman on a mission. A man, a woman on a mission to impart the kingdom of God. I want you to talk to God this hour. You are a man, a woman on a mission to impart the kingdom of God. You are not an ordinary person. I'd like you to talk to God this hour. Talk to God this hour. The Bible says, today when you hear his voice, do not harden your heart. He said, now is the hour of salvation. Today may be that day that will mark that turnaround. Today may be that day. Today may be that day that will mark that turnaround in your life. God has destined you to impart lives for his kingdom. You are a woman, a man of destiny. It is the will of God that you will fulfill destiny. You will fulfill your purpose here on earth. The blood of Jesus has taken away that veil. Whatever it is that you have allowed to bring back that veil, I want you by prayer this morning to pray that that veil will be lifted out of your life. Whatever it is that has suddenly put a veil over the glory of God upon your life, I want you to pray this hour. God will grant you the grace that you may be able, even as the Lord has enabled you, to disallow that which you have allowed into your life. so that for the purpose the blood of Jesus Christ was shed for you, it shall be fulfilled. Praise unto the glory of the Lord in Jesus' name. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray.